Students, I am sure you all are fine and safe at home. Students, as we have started our online classes and we have completed our chapter 1, soon you will get the notes of chapter 1 that you have to copy down in your bio registers. As we have started our chapter 2, now this is the third part of our chapter, Cell, the Basic Unit of Life. In our previous video, we have started discussing about the various cell organelles. We have seen that some cell organelles, they are single membrane bound cell organelles, some are double membrane bound organelles, and some are the organelles which are not having any membrane around them. Now, we have studied about mitochondria, Golgi apparatus, and endoplasmic reticulum. So, in this category, now we are going to study about plastids. The plastids, they are the kitchen of the cell. Why they are called the kitchen of the cell? Let's see. Plastids, they are the largest cell organelles which are found in the plant cell only. Remember, they are present in plant cell only. They are not present in the animal cell. These are also double membrane structure. Now, students, do you remember that in previous video I told you about one more cell organelle which is having double membrane? Yes, you guess it right. It is mitochondria, which is having a double membrane around it. Plastids, they are basically of three type: chloroplast, chromoplast, and leucoplast. So let's study with chloroplast. If you remember one word, that is chlorophyll, which is related to plant, which help the plant to prepare its food. So these are found only in green parts of the plant. They contain a green pigment called chlorophyll, which is needed for synthesizing food through photosynthesis. They contain their own DNA, RNA, and ribosomes. They synthesize their own proteins and also have the capacity to replicate. Hence, chloroplasts, they are also called semi-autonomous bodies. Now, again, students, I am asking you the question. In our previous video, we have discussed about one more semi-autonomous organelle. Do you remember? Yes, that is mitochondria, the powerhouse of the cell. It is also called as a semi-autonomous organelle because it can synthesize its own protein and it is having its own DNA and RNA present in it. Now, chromoplasts. These contain yellow, orange, and red pigments. They are mostly present in the petals of flowers and fruits. Leucoplasts. These are colorless plastids without any pigment. They don't have any pigment in it. Cells of potato tubers, rice grain, and maize grains, they have abundant of leucoplasts. Now let's see the functions of plastids. Plastids, as I told you, they are called the kitchen of the cell. Now let's see why they are called the kitchen of the cell. Chloroplast, it traps solar energy with the help of chlorophyll for manufacturing food during photosynthesis process. Therefore, they are called the kitchen of the cell. Second function of plastid is that they give beautiful colors to flowers and fruit. So as I told you that chromoplasts, these contain yellow, orange, and red pigment. Chromoplasts, they give characteristic color to the flowers and fruits, and they help in attracting insects and other animals for pollination and dispersal of fruits. Because of the beautiful colors of flowers and fruits, the insects and the other animals, they are attracted towards them, and these insects and other animals, they help in the process of pollination. Third is storage. Leucoplasts, it store food as carbohydrates, proteins, or oil. So leucoplasts, they store food in the form of carbohydrates, fats, and proteins. So these are the functions of plastids. Now our next cell organelle is vacuoles. Vacuoles, they are fluid-filled, membrane-bound, clear spaces in the cytoplasm. They are actually filled with water and they are having a variety of substances in them like minerals, sugar, carbohydrates, pigments, and metabolic waste in solution. Now in mature plant cell, a large vacuole occupies most of the center part of the cell. Now when it occupies most of the central part of the cell, all the other things like nucleus and other cell organelles in plant cell, they are pushed near the boundary wall. The vacuole, it is bounded by a membrane called tonoplast. The vacuole is filled with cell sap, which is watery solution. As I told you, they are rich in minerals, sugar, carbohydrate, pigment, and metabolic waste in solution. Now in animal cell, vacuoles, they are generally absent, or if they are present, they are present in a very small size, not like in plant cell. Now functions of vacuoles. They keep the cell turgid and they provide them rigidity and support. So the basic function of the vacuole is that they are providing the rigidity and support to the plant cell. They store food material and waste products. Contractile vacuole, they help in maintaining the water balance and in excretion. Sap vacuoles, they maintain osmotic concentration in plant cell needed for water absorption. Food vacuoles in protozoa, they help in the digestion of food. So basically, vacuoles, they help to maintain the osmotic pressure in a cell, that is called osmoregulation. They store toxic metabolic byproducts or end products of the plant cell. And the main function of the vacuole, as I told you, it is that they provide rigidity and support to the plant cell. Next cell organelle is lysosome, which is also called as the suicide bag of the cell. Now let's study why they are called the suicide bag of the cell and what are lysosomes. Lysosomes, they are found only in animal cell, means they are not present in the plant cell. They are actually spherical and sac-like vesicles which are bounded by a single membrane. So they are single membrane bounded organelle. These contain several digestive enzymes which are synthesized in rough endoplasmic reticulum, are concentrated in Golgi apparatus, and they are finally packed in lysosome. When these enzymes they get released in the cell, they bring about digestion of various cytoplasmic structure. If these enzymes they are released in the cell, they would result in autodigestion of the cell. Hence, lysosome, they are also referred as a suicide bag of the cell. Means they contain several digestive enzymes which are having the capacity that they can digest various cytoplasmic structure. But during breakdown of cell structure, when the cell gets damaged, lysosome, they disperse in the cell and they may burst an enzyme, they start eating up their own cell. So they do autodigestion of the cell, and therefore lysosome, they are sometimes referred as suicide bags of a cell. Now lysosomes, they serve as an intracellular digestive system, hence they are called digestive bags. Means they destroy any foreign material which enter the cell, such as bacteria and virus. In this way, they protect the cell from bacterial infection. So lysosome, though they are very important for the cell, but sometimes they become harmful for the cell because they start eating up their own cell material, and then they are called the suicide bags of the cell. Lysosome, they also remove the worn out and poorly working cellular organelles by digesting them to make way for new replacements. In this way, they remove the cell debris and are also known as demolition squads or scavengers, or you can call them cellular housekeepers. Thus, lysosome, they form a kind of garbage disposal system of the cell. So though they help in cleaning the cell, but they are also harmful for the cell because sometimes they start eating up their own cell, and in that case they become the suicide pack of the cell. We have studied about plastids, which are called the kitchen of the cell. We have studied about lysosomes, which are called the suicide bag of the cell. Now let's study about ribosomes, which are called the food factory of the cell. Now why ribosomes are called the food factory of the cell? Because ribosomes are the cell structure that makes protein. And we know that protein is needed for many cell functions, such as repairing damage or directing chemical processes. So ribosomes, they can be found floating within the cytoplasm, or they are attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. As if you remember in our previous video, we have discussed about it, that rough endoplasmic reticulum, they are having the ribosomes which are attached to them. Now what is the function of ribosomes? These are the sites for protein synthesis, hence they are called the protein factory of the cell. Now ribosomes, they are the smallest and spherical organelles. They are not bound by any membrane. They occur either scattered in the cytoplasm or they are simply attached to the surface of the endoplasmic reticulum, forming rough endoplasmic reticulum. These are formed of ribosomal RNA and protein. Now let's study about centrosome and centrioles. Centrosome, it is also not having membrane around it. It is found only in animal cell and the cells of some lower plants. It lies near the nucleus, and it appears as a rounded mass containing two small microcylindrical bodies, which are called centrioles. They lie at right angle to each other, and during cell division, they migrate to the opposite poles of the cell. Now, what is the main function of the centriole, centrosome? It forms a spindle fibers at the time of cell division, and basal bodies of cilia and flagella, they develop from centrioles. Prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. Do you know anything about prokaryotes and eukaryotes? In your previous class also, you have studied about prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Okay, if you don't remember, let me recall it again. What are prokaryotic cell? A prokaryote is a unicellular organism that lacks a membrane-bound nucleus, mitochondria, or any other membrane-bound organelle. Prokaryotes, they are divided into two domains, that is archaebacteria and bacteria. Prokaryotic cell, the characteristics of prokaryotic cells are that they don't have any nucleus, that they don't have nucleus. The nuclear material, that is DNA, it lies naked in the center of the cell and remains in direct contact with cytoplasm. Prokaryotic chromosome, it is form of a single circular DNA molecule. In prokaryotes, DNA is not associated with basic protein called histone. Ribosomes, they are smaller than eukaryotic ribosomes and they are scattered randomly in the cytoplasm. So these are some basic characteristics of prokaryotic cell. Now what are eukaryotes? Eukaryotic cells, they are the cells that contain a nucleus and organelles and are enclosed by a plasma membrane. Organisms that have eukaryotic cell, they include protozoa, fungi, plants and animals. Now what are the basic characteristics of eukaryotic cell? First, they have a well-organized nucleus with a definite nuclear membrane. Therefore, nuclear material or hereditary material is isolated from cytoplasm. The membrane-bound cell organelles like mitochondria, lysosome, Golgi complex, dicytosomes, endoplasmic reticulum, and chloroplasts, they are present and they are performing various specific functions, various functions. Now, multiple ribosomes are present, and ribosomes are bigger than prokaryotic cells. So, we the human being, we are having eukaryotic cell in our body, and the archaebacteria and bacteria, they are having prokaryotic cells in their body. Now, let's see the differences between plant cell and an animal cell. Plant cell, as I told you, that they are larger in size. They are larger in size in comparison to animal cell. Animal cell, they are smaller in size. Cell wall is form of cellulose and it is present outside the cell membrane. But in animal cell, there is no cell wall present. Means cell wall is absent. Cytoplasm, it forms a thin lining as it pushed to the periphery by vacuole. As we know that in plant cell, the vacuole is larger in size in comparison to animal cell. So the cytoplasm, they forms a thin lining and as they are pushed to the periphery by vacuole. Now cytoplasm, it fills the entire cell and is dense in animal cell. Nucleus is present towards the periphery, means towards the boundary of the cell wall, cell membrane. But nucleus, it is present in the center in animal cell. Plant cell, they have a permanent large central vacuole. In case of animal cell, they have a small or temporary vacuole and sometimes they don't have any vacuole in them. Plant cell, they have many simpler units of Golgi apparatus which are called as dicytosomes. But in animal cell, they have a single highly complex and prominent Golgi apparatus. So this is the end of our chapter. Now I will start your next chapter, tissues, in my next video. Thank you.